I am Deepak Phatak, teacher here, formally retired last year, but I still continue to be associated with various activities of our outreach program. I would share with you some of my thoughts in the first session, following which my colleagues will let you know about various projects that are ongoing here and around which your training program has been woven. I'm happy that almost 50 of them have come here, right? Few more to come in the next few days. You should be aware that there were more than 3,500 applicants, out of which you have the privilege and honor of getting selected. So congratulations. But I would also like to tell you there's a lot of hard work here. We believe in hard work. The primary objective must be that you learn as much as you can. And while learning, you contribute as much as you can to ongoing efforts. We hope to instill in you some of the professional practices that you'll be required to follow later in your lives when you pass out from your institutions and join either the industry or higher education or whichever. So you should get a glimpse of what happens. At IIT Bombay, we are reasonably proud of our heritage and our academic culture, and also our non-academic culture. Some of you would have known about Mode Indigo and TechFest and such events. They are considered to be largest events in the country, and they are all handled by only students. There is no faculty intervention in any one of those. What it means is that when you visit this place as students, you should ensure that you not only imbibe the academic culture of this institute, but you also imbibe the culture of Bonheim, working together, enjoying life, and living with energy and passion. That is what characterizes this campus. I hope it rubs on you for your short stay. Unfortunately, we had to curtail the internship program from 8 weeks to 6 weeks because of the changes in the national timetable of all institutions. So we have a hard deadline for vacating hostels whenever new students come in. And the deadline to begin the program is soft. It keeps getting extended every. In fact, I understand that one more day will be lost. There is a note from JE Advanced, which was supposed to be conducted yesterday, has been postponed to next Sunday.
No, Monday.
Next Monday. So next Monday will be a forced holiday. Of course, what we'll do is, because the exam is going to be conducted in the main computer science building, the neighboring building where our labs are, you won't have access to labs, but we'll arrange for some classrooms here where we could have some discussion session and you could catch up with your documentation and other things on that day. We'll make use of all the days. Before we begin formally, I thought we should have one quick round of introduction so that we know each other. Some of you will know each other by now because you are either staying in the same hostel or same wing or come from neighboring institutions or the same institution, but not all of you know each other. We certainly do not know you well. We'll know you well over a period of time and you will know us well. To begin with, I would like to introduce my team members here first, and then I would ask each one of you to introduce yourselves briefly, telling us which institution you are coming from and what are your interests and so on. Be brief in the introduction. We would not like to spend more than a minute per person. So to begin with, let me introduce my colleague, Mr. Aruna Adil. So Aruna actually heads our software development group for a particular activity, but this time she has taken up the mantle of organizing the entire internship program jointly with her colleague. So Rajnikant has been associated with Aruna for many years in several important software development projects. Rajnikant would also be has been helping her in conducting. We have several other senior managers who head respective groups of activities. I saw Pankaj here. So Pankaj Patil heads our group, which amongst other things does the creation of open educational resource repository. You all would be aware of the MIT's open courseware project. Well, the OER, IIT Bombay's policy has always been that the knowledge should be free, services could cost money. And therefore, all contents that we have created during training of teachers on large scale, we have trained more than 1,75,000 teachers in engineering colleges over the last 5 years. So all those contents of the workshops are to be released in open source. That's an undertaking we take, including an undertaking that you will also have to sign a similar undertaking. Suppose a teacher is participating from Kolkata or Coimbatore, and in our interactive sessions, which is a virtual classroom spanning the entire country, that person asks a question, and that question is answered. Curiously, as per the IP Act, the question belongs to that person. So if we want to include the question in the recording that is to be released in open source, we need that person's permission. Similarly, the faculty member answering that question, the exact answer and explanation belongs to that faculty member as the intellectual property. That is the care we need to take to ensure that we don't trample upon any IP ownership issues, and yet we ensure that the knowledge is transferred. So we take an undertaking even from the faculty member that he or she has no problem in releasing the recorded version of the question and answer in open source later after edit. You will also have to sign a similar letter for all the interaction that gets recorded here, and of course for all the work that you do. We also release most of our software developed here in open source. We also use most open source components in implementing practically everything that we do, including our cloud, which runs on OpenV storage, which is an open source software. We have of course developed the IIT Bombay X, which is the MOOCs platform developed on top of OpenEdX, and that is getting into a configurable version which can be used by any institution on a local server. Because it is open source, there is no cost for licenses, and it can be easily used and modified. The only condition is most of such open source comes under GPL license, which means that if I use it and if I make any modification, I am honor bound to release those modifications also in open source. I cannot keep those modifications to myself. So that is the rule that we follow here. So, Nagesh Karmali, he heads our fundamental research group. That is the name that they have given themselves. They do some research, but a lot of development as well. And they will be leading some activities. Next to him is Firuza Aybara. What is the particular activity that you are leading, Firuza? In? Acha, mobile app for this thing. Okay. Our cloud stalwarts are not here. I can see Sajjan here. Mr. Sajjan Dixit is in charge of our studio. As I told you, we have a blended MOOCs operation, which means that we not only run online programs, but we also have face-to-face interaction through a simulated classroom. We have over 500 remote centers, out of which about 250 participate in any one of our programs. So participants assemble at these 250 colleges. Interactive lectures are delivered in the morning from here, and in the afternoon the participants do their labs and tutorials in the local centers under the supervision of an expert. But all the interaction between us and them, which happens through internet and using a tool called AVU, which was developed by a sister institution, Amrita University, again released in open source, all of that connectivity, including our studio recordings of our video clips for MOOCs and editing and everything, is handled by a big team led by Sajjan. Incidentally, Sajjan learned all about video recording and editing after coming here. He is a hardcore programmer, by the way, professional. Of course, he still does some programming on the side, but his main job is to take care of this. Abhilash and anybody from his gang? Abhilash heads a group of system administrators which maintains two clouds. One cloud which we created in 1912-13-14, and another cloud which we have recently created for National Virtual Library of India. It is one of the largest clouds in the academic infrastructure of the country. It has 3 petabytes of usable disk space dedicated to NVLI work, and additionally about a petabyte for our own activities, including running the next version of IIT Bombay X and the OER repository and other things. So the system administrators, you would have encountered system administrators in your colleges. You never meet them? I'm asking the students. In your colleges, you would have servers which are handled by system administrators. You don't meet them. You know why you don't meet them? They are considered gods, so they remain away from human beings. But they are the ones who control every bit of access that you have to any server in your campus, like they do here. So here also we consider them as gods. And we also have an affordable solutions lab which was set up many years ago when the School of IT was set up, in order to try and find out technology solutions which can work at 1/5 or 1/3 of the prevailing cost. So affordability of technology is important for this country, and this lab has done variety of things, including the Akash project that you would have heard of. A lot of hardware modifications and integration was done by that lab, including Linux implementation on Akash, and software development of course was done by many. That lab is headed by my friend. Why are you sitting there? So why don't you introduce yourself?
Good morning all.
Yeah, you can speak, the audio is audible.
Good morning all. I'm Rajesh Kushalka, leading the Affordable Solution Lab. So major of the hardware activities and solution providing in affordable way is handled by our team out here in Affordable Solutions Lab. Thank you.
We have, of course, Sajjan's colleagues here manning the recording of this event as it goes on. That team is always visible in any interactive scenario. Anybody else from our teams here whom I forgot to introduce? Okay. The organizer is sitting at the back. You know him already, right? He is the one who is handling all your hostel logistics and whatever. Okay. He and one more person, Rahul. Rahul is outside. All right. So with this, I would now request you to introduce yourselves briefly, but instead of any arbitrary order, because for me to searching your name in the list of these 62 is not going to be easy. So what I'll do is I'll read out your name, and if you are here, you just raise your hand and start speaking. So the first name on my list is Gyanesh Prajwal from NIT Durgapur. Is he here? Yes, Gyanesh, tell me about yourself.
Sir, my name is Gyanesh R. Prajwal. So I'm from NIT Durgapur and I'm pursuing BTech
in what?
From CSE department. I'll be going to final year now.
Of which branch?
Sir, computer science engineering.
Computer science, okay. And what do you wish to pursue later?
So I'll go for higher studies.
I see. The next name I have is Anuja Modi. Anuja is not here right now. Vaibhav Popat from VNIT Nagpur.
Good morning, sir. I am a second year BTech student, computer science and engineering, VNIT Nagpur.
How did we end up selecting second year students? Oh, so you have to prove that you are exceptional, by the way.
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, you would normally not call you. So you have to do more work than what the third year I do.
Sure.
Okay, good. What do you pursue in VNIT?
Sir, I'm a computer science and engineering student.
Okay, good. Sakshi Sharma.
My name is Sakshi Sharma. I am from IIIT DMJ, Jabalpur that is. I am doing CSE and I'm in second year right now.
You are doing?
Computer science and engineering.
What degree you said?
BTech.
Oh, you have, I had visited Jabalpur. You still have a lot of incomplete buildings.
Yes, sir.
Are they getting
done? We are under
done?
Construction.
I know. Okay. Thank you, Sakshi.
Thank you, sir.
Navneet Agarwal. Yes, Navneet.
My name is Navneet Agarwal. I am from NIT Patna. Currently, I am pursuing BTech third year from Computer Science and Engineering Department.
Please sit down. Patna, NIT Patna is one of the oldest institutions.
Yes, sir.
Yes. I had visited that place several years ago. Who is your director now?
Pradeep Jain, Dr. Pradeep Jain.
Okay. Yes, yes, yes. Shreya Mishra.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, everyone. My name is Shreya Mishra and I'm from NIT Patna. Currently, I'm pursuing BTech in CSE and I'm in third year.
Third year, okay. And just because both of you are from Patna, you need not stick together always. You can mix with other people as well, process, yeah. Khushbu Shah, Nirma University. Khushbu has not yet joined. Sarthak Mishra.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, everyone. This is Sarthak Mishra from Siddhganga Institute of Technology, Tumkur, Bangalore. I'm pursuing BTech from Department of CSE. I'm in second year right now.
Oh, you are in second year?
Sir.
Very funny. So you have dubbed him also as an exceptional candidate. We have had some interaction with Tumkur a long time ago. They had sent some good students in earlier. If I'm not mistaken, are they also one of our remote centers? Tumkur, yes, they are. They're one of the better centers. So good, Sarthak. We hope that you do justice to the name of your institution and your own caliber.
Yes, sure.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Sanskriti Agarwal.
Hello everyone. My name is Sanskriti Agarwal. I'm from IIIT Jabalpur, Computer Science and Engineering, and I'm from second year.
You're also from second year. Aruna, I must once again look at your selection criteria. Now, I have nothing against you, but as I said, you will have to work harder to prove yourself. Right. So, Jabalpur. There are already two people from Jabalpur in this list, I see. Okay, thank you. My God. Is that because Aruna herself comes from not very far off from Jabalpur, from Raipur? So have you been partial to people from Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh?
This time one institute, 80 people have applied, 70, 80, 50 like that. So.
Okay, fine. Tanusha Mandala.
Good morning, sir. This is Tanusha from BIT Mesra. I'm currently pursuing third year from Computer Science and Engineering.
Mesra Ranchi, right?
Yes, sir.
One of the well-known institutions, very old institution.
Yes, sir.
Good. So I hope you will learn and also do work which is commensurate with the reputation of Mesra Ranchi.
Yes.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you.
Saurabh Vijay.
Good morning, sir. Sir, I am Saurabh Vijay. I am studying in MNIT Prayagraj. I am doing BTech in Computer Science and Engineering. And I am a student of second year.
Achha, Prayagraj is the new name to the old city of Allahabad.
Yeah,
right. When I had visited that year and a half ago, the whole city was under construction.
Yeah, sir,
I was visiting IIIT and it took me 1.5 hours to navigate through the city to reach that place. Now I hope it is better.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Great. I know of another Saurabh Vijay. He is Secretary of Higher Education, Maharashtra State. But what do you wish to pursue ahead after finishing?
I'm thinking of doing job in MNCs.
Right now. Job. Good. Amit Kumar Tiwari.
Good morning, sir. My name is Amit Kumar Tiwari. I am BTech third year computer science and engineering student at Madan Mohan Malviya University of Technology, Gorakhpur. Yeah.
Gorakhpur?
Yeah.
I see. And what do you wish to pursue in life?
I would like to do a job.
Job. Yeah. Suraj Goyal wishes to do a job. Samyak Bagra. Samyak has not come. Shivnadar University, okay. Dilip Singh Parihar. He comes from Meghalaya, so he must be somewhere near Andaman Nicobar. He'll eventually reach here, I guess. It's a complicated name. Shatra Jupali Vinay Kumar. Is he here? Ambar. No. Surbhit Avasthi. Not yet. Reshma Beti.
Good morning, sir. I am Reshma and I am from Rajiv Gandhi University of Knowledge and Technologies, Basar. And I am third year student.
And what do you wish to do ahead in your career, Reshma?
I would like to do job, sir.
Job, okay. Ritik Kumar.
Good morning, sir. Myself, Ritik Kumar from National Institute of Technology, Agartala. I'm currently pursuing BTech second year in Computer Science and Engineering Department.
Second year again.
I wish to pursue a higher degree after completion of my BTech.
I see. Good. Harsh Mohan.
Good morning, sir. I am Harsh Mohan from National Institute of Technology, Rourkela. I am pursuing BTech in Computer Science and Engineering and I am in second year.
You're also in second year. Rourkela has been one of the finest institutions. I had visited that when Professor Sarangi was the director many years ago.
Yes.
Who is your director now?
My name is Jaspas.
Gunjan Agarwal.
Good morning, sir. I am Gunjan Agarwal from National Institute of Technology, Hamirpur, Himachal Pradesh. I am currently in third year of Computer Science and Engineering Department.
And what do you wish to do ahead?
I want to go for placements only, sir. After BTech.
I see.
Yeah.
Sai Kumar Nalla.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Sai Kumar Nalla, and I am currently pursuing second year BTech in Computer Science from VJTL. And I wish to get a job after my BTech.
Good. Henil Jain.
Good morning, everyone. I am a student from VJTL. I am currently pursuing Computer Science Engineering BTech.
Which year you are in?
I have just completed my second year.
Same as him?
Yeah.
I see. And what do you wish to do in life?
Same as I would like to do a job.
A job.
Yeah.
Great. Okay. Mayank Agarwal.
Good morning. I am from PS University, Bangalore. Second year computer science. Mm. And I'd like to do something though very commonly pursued in machine learning, specifically along the lines of computer vision.
Nice. Good. Shankul Shukla.
Good morning, sir. My name is Shankul Shukla and I am from Guru Ghazidas University, Bilaspur, Chhattisgarh. I am in BTech third year, Computer Science and Engineering Department. I'd like to pursue higher education after a BTech.
Good. Harshit Mogalapalli.
I'm Harshit. Good morning, sir. I'm from NIT Trichy, pursuing BTech second year. I'm a second year student from CSC department.
Aruna, you have too many second year rights. Yes.
I worked on theoretical graph theory last semester. So I'm interested in research work.
I see.
But now, after getting this intern, I'll decide whether to go along hires or...
It doesn't matter. This internship is a very short duration. You're expected to learn a variety of things. Incidentally, let me tell you, or I will reserve my comments later. But let me mention this because he has brought up that topic. All of you will be working on a specific activity as your main theme. That is required to be done. So you are expected to do 8 hours honest to God work every day, including Sundays, Saturdays for that activity. You require 8 hours for your personal administration, food, sleep, whatever what. You are still left with 6 to 8 hours of work. Now that 6 to 8 hours you should utilize to learn as much else as you can from your colleagues, from the other projects that are going on. This is a place where you learn. My teacher and guru, Professor Kekre, used to tell me that if you work in a sugar factory, the least you get is a lot of sugar. So when you work in a knowledge factory, the least you should get is a lot of knowledge. It is moving around you. Only you have to sort of pick it up and so on. So don't worry about what you do in this 1.5. Whatever is your passion, as you develop it further, you should pursue it. Whether it is theoretical research, practical work, job, manager, entrepreneur,
no, anything. I am not getting correct guidance on development till now.
Okay, so let me again tell you my favorite thing. There are many people who will give you guidance, including me. My hobby, in fact, has been to give unsolicited advice to unsuspecting people. As a teacher, I do that. So you will get a lot of advice. But eventually, you have to take a call on what you wish to do. And remember one thing, you can never ever in life blame your decision on somebody's advice.
Yeah.
As a grown up, that taking your own decisions and living with the consequences is the hallmark of growing up. Yeah. You're already grown up. So seek advice, but your burst out tells me that you are perpetually waiting for some good advice. Don't do that. Start advising yourself and eventually take your own decision. And let me tell you, once you take a decision, never revisit that crossroad. Because every crossroad that you cross, later on in life, there will be ups and downs. And on every downturn, you will feel, "Arey yaar, if I should have not taken that decision." You never know what would have happened on the other roads. So never curse yourself for taking a decision. Stick to your decision and go ahead in life. But learn to take your own decisions. Take as much advice as it is amply available, including free advice. Thank you. Soumyakant Mahakul.
Good morning, sir. I'm Soumyakant. I'm from IIT Bhilai. I'm pursuing BTech in computer science and engineering, and I have just completed my second year.
I had visited IIT Bhilai.
Yes, sir.
That was
last year, I guess. Last year.
Oh, you were there, is it?
Yeah, I was there.
I see. So how is my friend Rajat Muna doing?
He's fine.
Well, yeah, good. So what do you wish to do ahead in life?
I'll go for job, I guess.
Go for job, okay. Bibhudatta Panigrahi.
Hello everyone. I am from IDSM Dhanbad. I am pursuing BTech in CSE and I have just completed my second year.
Arkam Sheikh.
Good morning, sir. I am Arkam Sheikh. I am from NITK. I am in Computer Science Department. I have completed my second year.
You have completed your?
Second year.
Second year. So Suratkal is one of the jewels in the NIT system. I hope you do justice to the name of that institution,
sir.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Who is your director currently?
Uma Maheshwar Rao.
Ah, Uma Maheshwar, correct. Thank you. Ajit Kumar.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Ajit Kumar and I am pursuing Bachelor of Technology in Computer Science and Engineering, and I have just completed my second year at IIT ISM Dhanbad.
And what do you wish to do ahead?
Sir, I would like to go for higher education.
Higher education, okay. Mohanlal Kalvania. No, he is also from Meghalaya, so both of them are transiting, I guess. Mayank Pal.
Hello everyone, my name is Mayank Pal and I am pursuing BTech from NIT Raipur. I have completed my third year and I am planning to do job after completing my BTech.
So in Raipur you have a very funny situation. You have an old government engineering college which houses NIT, which also houses IIT.
No, so actually it has changed.
I see.
Initially it was government engineering college, but now the campuses have changed, like GEC is different and NIT Raipur is different.
I see. Okay.
Yes, sir, but one more college is there and its name is also Government Engineering College itself.
But now there is a current older campus in the
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am.
Nikhil Jain. Another person from Jabalpur.
Sir, my name is Nikhil Jain. I am from IIIT DM Jabalpur. My branch is CSE and I am in BTech second year.
And what do you wish to do, Nikhil, ahead in life?
Sir, job.
Job. Anjum Bano.
Good morning, everyone. This is Anjum Bano from Motilal Nehru National Institute of Technology, Allahabad. Right now, I am in BTech second year, information technology student, and I wish to get a job after completing my undergraduation.
Good. Dwarshala Dikshita. Dwarshala is not here. Annamacharya Institute of Technology and Sciences. Where is this located? I don't know. It's not written here. Jitendra Gupta.
Hello, good morning, sir. My name is Jiten Gupta. I am from NIT Agartala. I am pursuing BTech in Electronics and Communication Engineering, and I would like to do a job.
Okay. Divya Kumar Patel from Gujarat, not here. Shweta Devsarkar, PNIT, Nagpur.
Good morning, sir. I am Shweta Devsarkar from NIT Nagpur, BTech second year student, and I'd like to do job after I complete my BTech.
Okay. Aishwarya Raj, NIT Patna again.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, everyone. I am Aishwarya Raj from NIT Patna. Right now, I am pursuing BTech in Information Technology, and I wish to do job after my BTech.
Which year you are in?
Third year. I've just completed my third year.
You just completed your third year?
Yes, sir.
And you want to do a job later?
Yes, sir.
Good. You belong to Patna itself or some nearby
Patna
place?
Itself.
Patna, sir. Somansh Reddy Satish.
Good morning, sir. My name is Somansh from Manipal Institute of Technology. I'm a third year student pursuing BTech in Computer Science, and I wish to go for higher studies after graduation.
For higher studies. Did we have anybody from Manipal earlier? I don't recall. We had one. I see. Shikhar Suman.
I am Shikhar Suman. I am currently pursuing my BTech second year in Electrical Engineering, and I am still undecided as what to do after my graduation.
I see. So as an electrical engineer, what useful things do you hope to find here?
Sir, I am proficient in both coding and code, so I like to do both.
Okay. Bhagya Lakshmi Gosula. Prasanjit Rath.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Prasanjit Rath. I am from IIT Bhubaneswar. I am doing BTech. I am from second year. I am doing BTech in Electronics and Communication. So basically, I wish to pursue a higher education. Thank you.
Nidhi Singh. Is already somebody from Hamirpur. So Nidhi is your colleague? Sorry? Oh, she is not going to job. Nice. But we would have paid 10,000 rupees for her as well. We'll have to recover that cost from the Ayush Agarwal.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Ayush Agarwal, and I have completed my third year of Computer Science and Engineering from Amity School of Engineering and Technology, Amity University, Noida. And I'm currently, I wish to pursue higher studies after graduation.
Nice. Akash Soni.
Sir, I am Akash Soni. I am from National Institute of Technology, Hamirpur, and I have completed my third year, and I wish to pursue job after my dual degree. Actually, I am from BTech M.Tech Integrated Dual Degree.
Oh, I see.
Yes, sir.
So, when will you finish your M.Tech after another
2021.
And you propose to pursue a job?
Yes, sir.
Good.
Thank you, sir.
Yashasvi Peruemba.
Good morning, everyone. I am Yashasvi, and I am from IIT Indore, and I just got done with my second year.
Nice. Second year computer science?
Yes, sir.
And what do you wish to do ahead?
Currently very confused, but inching towards higher studies.
I see. So, thank you for defining the correct state of mind. Many people don't admit it, but many people are confused. Not only at this stage, let me admit that even I get confused sometimes in life. But of course, I'm only 70 years old. I still have 30 years of active life. So hopefully I will get over my confusion someday or the other. But it's okay to be confused as long as you don't hesitate in taking decisions and going forward somewhere. To remain confused perpetually is not a good idea. Harsh Soni.
Hello, everyone. I am Harsh Soni. I am from NIT Raipur. I am currently in my third year BTech Computer Science and Engineering. I would like to do a job after BTech.
I see. Dimple Saluja.
Good morning, everyone. I am Dimple Saluja. I am from National Institute of Technology, Patna, and I have completed my pre-final year BTech CSE. And I would like to get a placement after my course.
Tushang Gupta.
Good morning, everyone. I am Tushang Gupta from BITS Pilani. I am a dual degree student of MSc Economics and BE Computer Science. I am in third year.
What is the complicated degree that you mentioned once again?
There are two separate degrees, MSc Economics and BE Computer Science. Five-year course.
MSc Economics and BE Computer Science.
Yes.
So, do they teach you at least some important elements of economics while you're doing your BE, or BE is purely CS and nothing
BE
else?
BE is purely CS. We do in third year courses from both the degrees, and in fourth year we do all the CS courses. And in second year we do courses from only economics.
Acha, acha. It's a complicated structure. I met your director recently at a conclave in Mussoorie. My friend B.N. Jain used to be there earlier as Vice Chancellor. Back in IIT Delhi now. It's a good institution. I hope you do justice to your selection here.
Yes.
Thank you. Aditya Bandal.
Good morning, sir. I am Aditya Bandal from VNIT Nagpur. I have completed second year B.Tech Computer Science and Engineering. I would like to go for higher studies.
Ankita Jain. Ankita has not yet come. Prachi Pandey.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Prachi Pandey. I have currently completed my third year from NIT Uttarakhand, and I am pursuing CSE.
Has there been any signs of development on the new campus? Your ex-director showed me a map where the land given was on some kind of a hill.
Sir, that land is unfit for any kind of construction.
And that is what I guessed at that time. So now you are getting some other land or?
No. We have been given a new land for construction of permanent campus.
So you are still operating from the temporary campus?
No, sir. We have been shifted to MNIT Jaipur.
Abba, the whole institute has been shifted.
Sir, from first year to third year.
I see. Interesting. Yes. God bless you. I hope things work out well. This is supposed to be the land of gods, I say, and such things are happening there, I don't know. But anyway, best luck. Ritu Gupta.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Ritu Gupta. I am studying in Amrita University, Bangalore. I just completed my third year B.Tech. And after graduation, I want to take some job experience and then I want to go for higher studies. Right now, I've not decided my field, but I have interest. I want to explore more. And right now, I'm interested in natural language processing.
Our expert in natural language processing is sitting in IIT Patna, Professor Pushpak Bhattacharya. But there would be people in Amrita as well who work on NLP, right?
Yeah.
Good. Mridul Mahajan.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Mridul Mahajan, and I'm a second year student from IIIT Allahabad. Moreover, I'm pursuing a dual degree course in information technology, and I'd like to specialize in computer architecture.
Shreya Kumari.
I'm from NIT Uttarakhand.
In Jaipur currently.
Yes, sir. Yes, and I have just completed my third year and I'm from CSE department.
CSE. And what do you wish to do, Shreya, in life?
I wish to get a job.
Simple and elegant solution to life. Neil Dani.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Neil Dani. I'm studying Computer Science Engineering at Manipal Institute of Technology. I'm just done with my third year and I'm interested in mathematics, especially stats, so I'd like to specialize in that.
I see. So Manipal means you are Somaj's batchmate? I see. Both of you from the same. Alright. S. Vijayalakshmi, I think there is some incomplete spelling. It says Na, N-A. Is that the name?
It's not applicable, sir.
Sorry?
It's not applicable.
And you print NA as a part of the name. Her whole name becomes non-applicable. Sorry for the syntax goof in our programming. Anyway.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Vijayalakshmi. I'm from RGKT, IIIT Basar, Telangana. I'm pursuing my B.Tech third year in the stream of Computer Science and Engineering. I would like to go for higher studies after completing my undergraduation. Thank you.
Is also someone else from Basar, right?
Yes, sir.
So is the same as our remote center in Basel, or this is different? You don't remember, all right. Pratik Gupta.
Good morning, everyone. I am Pratik Gupta, and I am a second year student pursuing BTech in CSE from IIIT Naya Raipur.
Oh, this is that IIIT based on the PPP model or something?
Yes, sir.
Where state government is supposed to give some funds and the private partner is supposed to give some funds.
Yes, sir. NTPC and
state. And actually none of them give any funds. So, are you okay with the funds right now?
Yes, sir.
I see. So, you have a campus and well-established institution.
Campus is well-established.
Good, good. Keep it that way.
Thank you, sir.
What do you wish to pursue further, Pratik?
Sir, currently I'm not very sure, but I think I would go for jobs.
You would go for a job. Mahesh Sharma.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Mahesh and I'm from VIT Vellore. I'm a third year going student, a CSE student, and I'll be going for placements.
You study in Vellore itself?
Yes, sir. Sir, I am from Jaipur. I'm studying in VIT Vellore.
Jaipur to Vellore?
Yes, sir.
Uttarakhand to Jaipur. Now we have to find out somebody who is moving to Uttarakhand from south, then the triangle will be completed. Vellore is a good place. I had visited it some 20 years ago when it was just coming up as a good institution. Now it's a well-established.
Yes, sir. Now it's a well-established university, but
you have too many students on the campus though.
Sir, around 30,000.
Yeah, that's right. So what is the target, 1 lakh or something? Don't know.
Don't know, sir.
Okay. Abhishek Savalkar.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, everyone. My name is Abhishek Savalkar. I am pursuing my BTech from I have just completed my third year from NIT Raipur. I would pursue my higher studies after
completing. Saurabh Sahu.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Saurabh Sahu. I am from NIT Raipur and I am pursuing my BTech in Computer Science and Engineering. And in future, I'd like to appear for civil service examination.
Oh, first person who is one. You know, there are a lot of, I recently gone to Mussoorie for a conclave where I met 6 of IIT Bombay students who have joined the IS program this year. So it's good to see that somebody is interested in pursuing that. Well, thank you so much. So I have already made some comments during the interaction. I think some more people might come, those who are missing there. At least one or two are not coming definitely, as was pointed out, but that is okay. As you recall, I said your internship program had to be cut down from 8 weeks to 6 weeks. 8 weeks itself is a very short duration, 6 weeks is still shorter. What it means is that every day is important, as it is important even otherwise. But you should take maximum use of every moment that you spend on the campus here. I will just give you my concluding remarks. Once again, welcoming you to this place. The concluding remarks, the first part I would like to say again is please utilize as much of this campus as you can. There is an ethos that runs through that campus. It cannot be described in words, it cannot be written down. Ethos is what you feel when you live on the campus. And it percolates into every dimension of life here, whether it's your hostel life, whether it's your food, including not very good food. But then you are all used to hostel food, I guess, most of you. So that's okay. You can live and you can survive. But more importantly, your professional work here and the guidance that you will get. Please understand that we have about 50 or 60 technical staff members who are working on different projects. They're all high priority projects. They're all operational systems which work, whether it is our MOOCs platform or whatever other thing that we do. And therefore, it is absolutely important for them to concentrate full time on their work. They will be spending a lot of their time in handholding your activities. So please utilize that time as much as possible. Don't expect any spoon feeding. That does not happen in IIT Bombay environment. As I said to my friend here, that in life you have to take your own decisions and live with the consequences. Similarly, on technical matters, don't hesitate. Take a decision, go ahead. Okay. Particularly when you are doing work with a computer, you have a great advantage. The computer never shouts back at you. So you can take pangas. At the worst case, the program will crash. You'll have to redo something. Don't hesitate in retrying till you succeed. There'll be n number of things that you will be learning here. Learn them as well as you can. And as I said, two important objectives that should be very clear and uppermost in your mind. Number one, you must learn something new, more than what you already know. And number two, you must contribute meaningfully to some ongoing activity that is going on, because the institute is investing a lot of money. Please understand that because the end of that government, there is no new government in place. For last 8 months, we have no new funding that is coming from government. We are actually living a hand-to-mouth existence. And from the salary budget that we have, which is already limited, I had to take a decision to carve out some money to pay for your academic charges to IIT Bombay, which have been suddenly enhanced from 6,000 rupees to 10,000 rupees per person. When we had good funding, we used to also pay some out-of-pocket allowance to participating students, which we are, of course, unfortunately not able to do that. I hope you are okay with that, meeting your own expenses for your travel and stay here. We can't do anything about it. If anyone has a genuine and desperate problem, that person can meet me independently without any this thing, and I can share the difficulties if you have, but I hope that all of you are well. The academic fees is being paid by the project to the institute, so that you can consider to be your sort of salary, 10,000 rupees for 1.5 months of work here. Okay, of course it is paid to the institute, not paid to you. I only advise all my students to follow a simple principle to make your life as beautiful as dewdrops. You have seen dewdrops in the morning on the petals of trees and the flowers. They look beautiful, right? So I expand the word dew in a very peculiar fashion. For me, D means dream big. So you must dream big. Many of you describe that you want to do a job. That's a good dream, but that's not a big enough dream. What job? What do you want to do in that job? How do you want to impact not only your life and your family life, but the life of others, life of the company? When do you wish to become a CEO of the company that you join? Those are big dreams. So a job after your degree is actually a small milestone. And having decided on that milestone, don't close your dreaming mind. Think of doing beyond that. Think of 20 years, think of 30 years. Dream big. Because unless you dream big, you cannot achieve extraordinary things. Your dreams always will limit whatever you achieve. So D is for dreaming big. E is for enjoying life. Enjoy everything that you do. Enjoy the programming that you do. Enjoy the work that you do. Enjoy the arguments that you have. You must enjoy absolutely every instance. You know why? Because time is the only thing in the commodity in the world which is one-way traffic. If you lose money, you can always earn it. If you forget something, you can refresh it. But time, any instance that goes past, gone. In your entire life, it will never come back. And therefore, you must make the best use of every instant. So enjoy everything. Enjoy arguments, enjoy fights. The most enjoyable thing will be the argument with your parents, I guess. But whatever it is, enjoy everything fully. Make best use of every instance. This enjoyment is curtailed sometimes because of the hard things that you have to face in life. As I told you, life always has ups and downs. And there will be problems, there will be disasters, there will be failures. So you will have to cry over failure because that's a human nature. But my theory is that don't give that cry more than 24 hours. You sleep over it, next day morning when you see the new sun, you should say, ah, the new instance has arrived, that must be enjoyed. So please ensure that you recover from any failure of yours, whether it is small, whether it is big or whatever, and continue to enjoy life. That is E for you. And last, W is for working hard, because you cannot create history without working hard. We are all, as humans, we are natural optimizers, you know, minimize work, maximize gains. And you are all smart human beings. So you are better optimizers than most. But let me tell you that for 4,000 years, people much smarter than us have attempted to find a substitute for hard work. No one has succeeded so far. If you really want to dream big and create history, then you have to work hard. There's no shortcut to it. So dream big, enjoy life, and work hard. God bless you.